Hi, and welcome to a Deck Tech video about Estrid the Masked and how she combos with the Chain Veil. Her first ability will untap each enchanted permanent you control, and her minus one ability will enchant stuff. So those two abilities are key in this combo, and using her minus one to enchant the Chain Veil, so now Chain Veil will be untapped with her first ability. And then a minus 7 will be, put the top 7 cards of your library into your graveyard, return all non-aura enchantment cards from your graveyard to the battlefield, then do the same with aura cards. So it is a bit tricky to execute this combo. Everything is coming down to what loyalty count Estrid currently is on, and we will be explaining a lot of that in this video, so let's take a look. Alright, so this is how we're going to win with Estrid the Masked and Chain Veil. So we cast Estrid from the command zone. She costs 4. She comes into play with 3 loyalty counters, but we are going to activate this land's ability that will put an extra loyalty counter on our planeswalker commander. So she goes up to 4 loyalty counters. We're throwing this away because we don't need it anymore. It's done its importantly job. We activate her ability once, her normal ability, minus 1, to put a mask onto the Chain Veil. Then we tap this forest for 3 mana and 1 more land for 1 more mana to activate Chain Veil. We have now activated Chain Veil once this game. This means that we can activate our commander, so we activate her once for 5, untapping everything. Then we tap all our lands. We have our Wild Growth and Snow Covered Plain that will give you 2 mana. This thing will tap for 2, so that's 4 mana, and this thing will tap for 3, so that's a grand total of 7 mana. We now use 4 of the mana, goes down to 3 mana in the mana pool, and activate Chain Veil once more. We have now activated Chain Veil 2 times this game. Plus Estrid, untap everything, and re-tap your mana. We now have 10 mana in our mana pool. We consume 4 of the mana. Yeah, we have 6 more mana in the mana pool, and we activate Chain Veil, and it goes up to 3. Now, what we're going to do is that we're going to ultimate Estrid, killing her, and sending her to the command zone. Recast Estrid for the 6 mana that we have accumulated through this process. Now she comes into play with 3 loyalty counters, and this is where the Chain Veil becomes a loop and goes infinite, because the Chain Veil activations are not linked to a specific permanent in play. They are linked to a player, and they are linked to me playing Estrid. That means that currently Estrid can activate 3 times out of the blue, and because she hasn't activated herself this turn, she can activate 4 times this turn. So we begin with activating her once, generating 7 mana because we untap these permanents and tap them again. This will also untap Chain Veil, and she will go up to 5 loyalty. What we do now is that we pay 4 mana, it goes down to 3. Activate Chain Veil, goes up to 4. This increased to 4. We plus her ability, plus 2. Untap everything, including these. Tap these once more, go up to 10. What we're going to do now is that we're going to activate her once more in a basic way to go up to 9. Untap all these, tap them. We now have 17 mana in our mana pool, and we have 3 more activations this turn. What we're going to do is that we're going to ultimate her. She goes down to 2. She has 2 more activations for 3 out of the blue left, and we will use those to kill her, putting 2 more masks onto anything. Doesn't really matter because she's going to die. She goes to the command zone, and we have untapped Chain Veil and 17 mana in the mana pool. So what we're going to do is that we're going to consume 8 of the mana from the 17, so this will go down to 9 mana remaining in our mana pool. We cast Estrid the Masked. She comes into play with 3 loyalty counters, and we can activate her 4 more times out of the blue, increasing by her normal basic way. So from here, we are going to infinitely be able to produce infinite mana and infinite cast Estrid the Masked trigger. So her minus 7 is, put the top 7 cards of your library into your graveyard, return all non-aura enchantments cards from your graveyard to the battlefield, then do the same with aura cards. So what we have here is infinite Estrid ultimates together with infinite mana. So we will be able to bring every little enchantment from our deck into play. Now, how I plan to win is with Blind Obedience and Extort. So each time that we cast Estrid, we can pay 1 more white mana, and each opponent lose 1 life, and you gain 1 life for each life lost this way. This means that we're going to deal infinite loss of life to all our opponents by recasting Estrid over and over. And remember, we did fetch this thing from our deck with her ultimate ability bringing all enchantments back from the graveyard into play. Great success!
Now, if we don't have Forge of Heroes, we are in a bit of a tricky situation. Because let's cast Estrid from the command zone. She comes into play with 3 loyalty counters, -2 to put the mask onto the Chain Veil. Now, each time you activate Chain Veil and Estrid, you will generate more mana. As long as you're generating more than 4 mana from this, you will generate infinite mana in the long run. However, she goes up from 2 to 4, she goes up from 4 to 6, and from 6 she goes up to 8. And if you wanna ultimate her, she will go down to 1, meaning that she's going to stick on the board state, and she won't go back to the command zone. Sure, you will flip top 7 cards and put all enchantments from their graveyard into play. But if that is not scoring your win, you're stuck. You need to kill her somehow. And the part where Forge of Heroes were able to put her on a 4 loyalty counters in the beginning and throwing her down to 3 and then climbing from 3 to 5, 5 to 7 and from 7 to 0 would mean that you could infinitely loop Estrid. However, we still got something. We still generate infinite mana. She will actually claim infinite loyalty counters, but also infinite land untaps. And all you really need now is something of a land that is enchanted that can do something. So let's say that one of the land cards that we are using to generate infinite mana with an aura like Dawn's Reflection is this, Arch of Orsaka. It's a land that comes into play untapped. It taps for colorless mana, for 5 mana and tap it, draw a card. Activate this ability only if you have the city's blessing. This means that we can draw our entire deck because we are able to untap this land with Estrid the Masked. Now with your entire deck in your hand, you begin with casting Blind Obedience. After that, with infinite mana and your entire deck in your hand, keep just casting every single card you have in your entire deck and keep extorting your opponents until all of them dies. You can even cast Force of Will, targeting your own Carpet of Flowers or War of Inventions. Just remember that you don't activate the Relic of Prognetus to draw a card from this. Just keep casting your cards and extorting all of your opponents with this. Quite cool. However, there could be more cards inside your deck that will be able to draw your entire deck, like Thrasios, the Triton Hero. So from here, we can calculate that if we have anything that will search our library for a land card or a creature card and put it into play, we should have the game from infinite mana. So in other words, it's quite similar to how Prosh functions, as Prosh generates infinite mana with a one card combo called Food Chain, and Estrid can generate infinite mana with one card combo called the Chain Veil. However, both Prosh and Estrid needs an outlet, some way they can win from infinite mana. And one way is to draw your entire deck with either Thrasios, the Triton Hero, who is a legendary creature card, and this Arch of Osaka, that is our land card. But we could also do the thing with Forge of Heroes to infinitely loop Estrid in and out and use her ultimate ability to bring Blind Obedience into play and then kill all of your opponents by infinitely cast Estrid the Masked. Something that you can also do is set her up for the next turn. So use her minus ability immediately to put a mask onto Nyctus. She now has 2. And then your next turn, you cast Chain Veil and minus her one more time to go down to 1 and put a mask onto Chain Veil. And then you activate Chain Veil and then you climb from 1 to 3, from 3 to 5, and from 5 to 7, and from 7, you ultimate her. And then you have the loop. I didn't think this was going to be that efficient, but something I discovered during playtesting was that it was quite efficient to cast Estrid from time to time when you didn't have anything better to do to just put masks onto different permanents that you thought were going to be efficient and good when you were going to do the combo run, but also on permanents that you want to protect a little bit. However, let's jump back to the part on what cards could win the game for us once we have infinite mana. So we have this land card, so anything that will fetch it will also score a win, like Knight of Reliquary, sacrifice a Plains or a Forest and search a library for a land card like this one. Then we have Crop Rotation, sacrifice a land, replace it. Pierce Whim. I actually like the card. Even though it costs 4 mana, this will put our land card into play. However, we need to put an enchantment onto this afterwards, an aura that will untap so that Estrid can infinitely untap this land. We also have Tolarian West and Sylvan Scrying. However, having a lot of land fetches isn't bad in a green deck, because we have Sera's Sanctum that will tap for a lot of mana in an enchantment deck. We also have Nyctus, Shrine to Nyx, and we have a proxy Gaia's Cradle. I'm an amateur, I'm doing my best. So in other words, we totally have 6 cards currently that could win the game. But we did also mention that we did play Thrasios Triton Hero. Now he is a legendary, that means that Captain Cisse is also going to be a win con from the infinite mana, because Captain Cisse can tap and find Thrasios Triton Hero and then just cast it. Now one more thing to point out, that Cisse can also find Chain Veil. So Cisse will also help you find this thing, but also when you have the infinite mana, will also help you find the Merfolk. We can also draw our entire deck with Staff of Domination. And because Staff of Domination is an artifact for 3 mana, Whir of Invention will also be a win con if you have infinite mana, because this can find Staff of Domination. And it's the same thing, Whir of Invention can also find the Chain Veil. So now we have 5 more cards that will win the game instantly. However, we also mentioned that Forge of Heroes would be an instantly win con. Now we're looking at something a little bit more obscure. It's not going to win the game instantly, because what you're going to do is generate infinite 1/1 green squirrel creature tokens, and that will swarm your opponents in the next turn. This will also help out making lands untap with Estrid, because this is an aura, it will enchant onto a land card. And this is also revealing that we have an alternative win con inside this deck. We have, sorry, not that one, Earthcraft. We're just playing the Squirrelcraft combo with squirrels and Earthcraft. So what you do is that you enchant your squirrel nest onto a basic land. You tap this land to generate a squirrel. You tap the squirrel and activate Earthcraft's ability and untap this land, and then you create infinite 1/1 squirrels. Quite old school. Let's reveal an alternative win con inside this deck, still Earthcraft. Let's put Naxxar Click up here. So Naxxar Click is a very strange fairy. So let's say that we have forest in play. So let's put Utopia Sprawl onto that forest and say blue. Tap this thing for blue and green. And then you activate Earthcraft's ability by tapping Naxxar Click to untap this land. And now you use the mana you generated to untap Naxxar Click, and target opponent removes the top card of his or her library from the game. Until end of turn, you may play that card. We don't need to play the card, because this is going to infinitely exile all your opponent's libraries from the game. However, if you have a better enchantment land aura, like Dawn's Reflection, you will also generate infinite mana, and that's cool, it's unnecessary and overkill, but I like to mention it anyway. However, let's actually go overkill. Let's put Market Festival and Dawn's Reflection on this basic land. So Market Festival, this land taps for 2 additional mana of whatever color whenever it taps for mana. Dawn's Reflection is a, you could call it a copy of it. And if you have Earthcraft in play, every single creature card will now tap for 5 mana. And let's bring back that Staff of Domination. Once a creature card can tap for 5 mana, it can generate infinite mana with Staff of Domination. Because you activate this ability for 3 mana, untap target creature, then 1 mana, untap Staff of Domination, and in this process you will generate 1 more mana each time you do this loop. Meaning you will gain infinite mana and infinite draw a card. And then with your entire deck in your hand and infinite mana, you could either win with Blind Obedience, like we've demonstrated before, or Naxxar Click. We actually have one more win con inside this deck, Stasis. Players do not get an untapped face. Pay 1 blue during your upkeep or Stasis is destroyed. Cards still do not untap until the next untapped phase. However, with Estrid the Masked, you are able to continuously untap enchanted lands that can produce blue mana. So you are able to survive this and keep everything tapped out. It is not a win to a 100% sure, because eventually your opponents will be able to put lands into play untapped, and then eventually have 3 lands untapped from just playing land cards,
and then he can cast Cross and Grip and destroy Stasis. And that will get him out of this stacks hold. However, by that time, you probably have an enormous board state that is going to be quite difficult to catch up to. And lastly, I would like to show you guys a kind of cool card. This is Sunken Field, Enchanted Land. Enchanted Land has tap, counter target spell unless its controller pays 1. But it's also going to help Estrid to combo off, because you put this onto a land card, and now that land will function into a combo. So this will increase the auras you have on the lands, on the same time giving you some form of interaction towards your opponents. However, when you start including cards that will untap lands, it's starting to get a little bit more nasty. In any case, this is it for this deck tech, and I'll see you guys in the next video.